So we are going to factorize
the given expression
by method number 1, that is common factors method. So first method is of common factors method. So here, now common factors, in this common factors method,
first of all we find the highest common factor, that will be called as HCF in abbreviation, of all the terms in the given polynomial. The latter, we will divide each and every term of the given polynomial or the given expression by means of the HCF or the highest common factor which we got it. The latter, by dividing the each and every term by HCF, we will be getting a quotient. We will enclose that quotient within the brackets. The latter, we will keep the common factor which we got, that is the highest common factor which we got, in front of the brackets. So this method will be called as the common factors method. So here, in this common factors method, or in this method, first, that is first of all, we find the highest common factor, highest common factor, or in abbreviation form, that is HCF. So first of all, we will find the highest common factor of all the terms in the given polynomial the given polynomial, then we divide each term of the given polynomial by the highest common factor and we will enclose the quotient. So here we will be getting this quotient by dividing each and every term by means of this HCF, then we will be getting this quotient. So this quotient must be enclosed. So here, enclose the quotient within the brackets. By keeping the common factor, that is highest common factor, outside the bracket. So here, in this method, so first of all we will find the highest common factor, that is HCF, of all the terms which are given in the polynomial or the given expression. The latter, we will divide each and every term of the polynomial which is given, of the given expression, by means of the HCF which we got. The latter, we will keep that quotient within the bracket. So after dividing each and every term by means of HCF, we will be getting a quotient. So that quotient must be kept within the brackets. Then later I say we will be keeping a common factor which we got as HCF in front of the bracket. So here this is the method by which we can find out the factors of the given expression. So here let us go for one example or for instance. For instance, factorize x cube minus 3x square . So we have to factorize x cube minus 3x square. So this is a binomial consisting two terms. The first term is of x cube with coefficient as 1 and the second term is of 3x square with the negative sign. So we have to write the factors of the expression, given expression, that is x cube minus 3x square. So we are utilizing now the method called the common factors method. So here factorizing the given expression, that is x cube minus 3x square. So this is the given expression we are going to factorize. So here by common factors method. So here we are going to factorize the x cube minus 3x square, the given expression, by means of the method called the common factors method. Then now first of all we have write the factors of each and every term, that is the first step. So we are going to follow the first step, that is the factors of first term, that is x cube, that it can be written as, so factors of x cube are, so here x into x into x. So x and x, these are the factors of x cube. Similarly, we have to write the factors of the second term, that is 3x square, that is equals to 3 is one of the factor, that is the constant, then x square can be written as x into x. So here these three are the factors of the term, that is 3x square. Then now we have to find out the common among these two factors. So here x is present, or x is the factor of x cube. Similarly, x is the factor of 3x square. So here x is a common factor of both the terms x cube and 3x square. Similarly, one more factor of x cube is x. So here x is also the factor of 3x square. That means, so x is the common factor for both the terms, that is x cube and 3x square. There is none other, because x is present, x is the factor of x cube, but it is not the factor of 3x square. Then 3 is a factor of 3x square, but it is not a factor of x cube. So here only x and x are the factors. So here therefore the highest common factor of x cube and 3x square terms is equals to, the highest common factor can be written in this manner. Either you take x into x of only one term, or either you take x into x of the second term, or in other words we can take, so x and x is common, since x and x is the common factor, so x is the common factor of both the terms, and one more x and x, that is x, one more x is the common factor of both the terms. Or simply we can write x and x, we can take as here factors of only one term, that gives us the highest common factor. Either you take the factors of x cube term, first term, or the factors of the second, that is the 3x square term. Or else we can take the common, say your common factor, say your common factor is x, then the second common factor is x. So highest common factor will be, so x into x is equals to x square. Hence, highest common factor is equals to x square. Then in the next step, so this is the first step. In the first step, we have to find out the common factors of each and every term. So this is step number 1. In step number 2, we have to divide each and every term of the given polynomial by means of this highest common factor. So here, then the next step, so given polynomial is of x cube minus 3x square. So each and every term must be divided by means of the highest common factor. So here, totally have divided by means of x square, we can write it as partially x cube by x square minus 3 square by x square. Then immediately we have to keep what I say here as highest common factor in front, or in other words, so we have to divide and multiply. So here we are multiplying and dividing the given polynomial with by means of the HCF. So here we got this step by multiplying and dividing polynomial, that is given polynomial, that is given polynomial by highest common factor. Then now the next logical step will be of, so that implies, so x square I am going to write as it is in front of this bracket, but I want to divide, so each and every term by means of x square, that means of by means of partial division. So I want to divide this complete polynomial by means of x square, then that implies x square into first term is of x cube, that must be divided by means of x square, minus second term is of 3x square, also must be divided by means of x square. So here we got this step by means of partial division. So by means of partial division, so we have divided each and every term of the given expression by means of HCF, that is highest common factor, say x square. Then that implies x square must be written as it is. Then now here x cube can be written as x repeated thrice, or we can apply the formula a power m by divided by a power n. So here x square can be written as x into x. So minus x square and x square gets cancelled because there is into in between 3 and x square. So 3 is left over, 1x and 1x in the numerator, x and x in the numerator will be gets cancelled. So that implies, so x square into only just x is left over, then minus 3. Hence x minus 3 is one of the factor, then the other factor is of x square. So here x square, the given expression is of, hence x cube minus 3x square is splitted or written as the product. So this is the product of two factors, that is x square and as well as the x minus 3. If you multiply, x square into x is of x cube minus x square into 3 is of 3x square. Therefore, these two are the factors of the given expression. Hence, therefore, x square and x minus 3 are the factors of given expression, that is x cube minus 3x square.